Well, I'm on the phone with head football coach Mark Shields from the MDI Trojans. And coach, you're not going to be wearing shorts tonight, are you?
No, I'm going to have the long pants on. So far this year, I am 0-1 in shorts.
Well, that's good enough reason not to wear shorts.
Yeah. So we're going to go with the pants. More to do with the fact that, it's going to be a little cooler tonight compared to some of the other games we've had so far. So, more like football weather.
Well, temps in the 40s tonight. And, I had to dig out an overcoat lot tonight because, I'm not in the plush MDI box where the sun shines on during the day. So I'm expecting to have to gut it out and kind of be cold up in the press box tonight.
Yeah, I think it will get pretty chilly. Probably. I bet in the second half it's going to get real chilly. I didn't bring my long underwear. And now that you see it's going to be down in the 40s, I'm thinking maybe I should have.
If we see you pacing along the sidelines tonight, we'll know you have not slipped home to get those.
Yeah, well, I wonder if I called my wife at work that she would run home. I'm going to be without my long underwear.
Yeah. All right, so tonight's another one of those big games, and you look out on paper, and this is the Class D defending state champions against the Class C North champions, and it should be a great game tonight.
Yeah, I was thinking about that the other day, and I don't know if that's ever happened before, having two Northern Maine champions from the past year play, and then, of course, MCI won the state championship. So, yeah, that's pretty cool, and, everybody's thinking this is going to be a close game, and we surely are. We have to go to them, and they haven't lost many games down there in Pittsfield, and a lot of tradition, as we talked about before, and very well coached, and just a good football team, So, this is a big one. It's a big one for both of us because, once again, you're dealing with heel points, and both teams are going to be worth a lot of points.
Yeah, no question.
And both teams need those points. So, both teams know that this is a crucial point in the season, and both teams really want to win. So, for multiple reasons.
And MCI really one of those has become a football town in Pittsfield.
Yeah, no doubt about it. I mean, they have been to three straight Northern Maine championships, won those, and then they've been, of course, to the three state titles and won the last one. So, yeah, they are definitely a football town, and credit to Coach Bertrand, when he first went down there. We didn't play them, but just following them, through the newspaper and, through the news channels, it seemed like they were down a little bit. And then he comes in, and he had a few tough years, but then they got it rolling, and they haven't stopped. They haven't looked back. They've been top of the pack for, the last 3 or 4 years, and here they are once again, move up a class, and they're still at the top of the pack. So they're, quality program.
Well, we don't have any of their stats from last week against Cape Elizabeth. We have their first the first 3 weeks. And certainly one of the players you have to keep an eye on is Adam Bertrand, who is the coach's son, 40 carries, 252 yards, 4 touchdowns.
Yep, for sure. Number 6, you look at him on tape, and I haven't seen him live, but just looking on tape, he's a big, strong kid, and he's hard to bring down, and they'll use him in multiple sets. The thing about MCI, what we found this week, is they have multiple formations that they run offensively, and they do multiple things out of those formations. So they're a handful to prepare for because of that reason alone. When you have a team that has multiple formations, then you have to teach your team how to deal with each formation. And so we've worked hard on that this week. But, his son, the Bertrand kid, he's the real deal. He's also a really strong defensive player. They'll move him around defensively, play some linebacker. Sometimes they'll put him at free safety, and they'll blitz him for free safety. He does a lot for them, special teams, whatnot. So, he's a guy that if we can't stop tonight, we're going to be in a lot of trouble.
They seem to have a big big line because they're rattling off 6.4 yards per carry for the first through the first three games.
Yeah, we talked about that on Monday, Chris. They're big and strong up front. You know, I know their strength coach, Woody Moore, a guy I went to Skowhegan with, and you know, and you can tell he's had those guys lifting hard. And I mean, you're not that successful, you know, like they've been without being strong. And you can tell they look like football players in pads. I mean, there's some muscles bulging out of those pads.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, they're strong. And they'll go offensively, they'll go toe-to-toe many times with their front line splits. And they'll almost, like a snowplow, they'll just roll you over. So you see that on tape, and you know that those kids are strong to be able to do that. So, yeah, they're going to be a handful up front.
They certainly like to pass the ball. I mean, when you look at their opening season game against Oceanside, 19 of 38 for Ryan Friend for 202 yards. And then Nokomis, they only threw the ball eight times. And then against Belfast, they were 5 of 15 for 87 yards. So they're not afraid to put the ball up in the air.
No, they're not. And you know, you'd think where they have a freshman quarterback that they wouldn't be throwing the ball that much, but they do, and they have confidence in him. And they scheme that very well. I mean, they have those tight splits up front, so it's hard to get any pressure on him. Plus, they do a nice job getting him out of the pocket. They'll roll him right or left to protect him and give him more time. And he's an accurate thrower, and he's got kids he can throw the ball to. He has some good athletes out there. So, yeah, I mean, just like we've been talking about with our offense this year, you know, a team that has more diversity is going to be tougher to stop because you have more things to worry about. And, you know, sure enough, they can run and throw. So that becomes a problem for us defensively because there's a lot you got to think about.
They seem to be almost like a mirror image of MDI. You know, obviously not going in the tee, but with what they like to do and the success that they have.
Yeah, no doubt about it. I mean, you're right. First and foremost, they want to run the football. You know, it's interesting you see that with all the spread offenses you've been seeing, you know, the last, whatever, 5, 6, 7 years. You know, still a lot of the top teams, when you think about a Winslow, you think about an MCI, you think about MDI, you know, those three teams still want to run the football. They still want to pound the ball. But, you know, all three teams can throw the ball as well. And sure enough, you know, we got that, you know, on our side this year for the first time probably in a while, where we feel pretty confident throwing the football. And that's credit, you know, to our quarterback, Andrew Phelps, and the receivers we have to throw the ball to and our offensive line to protect him. So they feel the same way. You know, they have no fear of rolling that kid out and throwing the ball, and he's accurate. He's been right on the tapes that we've seen. He doesn't throw many picks. You know, he's pretty accurate with what he's doing. So, you know, defensively, that's going to be, you know, something that if we can't stop tonight, then we're probably going to lose the football game.
Do you, you've had great success on your opening drives. Do you take the ball or do you want to defend if you win the opening coin toss?
Yeah, that's a great question. I've been thinking about that. And many times games like this on the road, we have kicked off. You know, we've done that a lot against Winslow the last few years. When we feel like this game is going to be a real dogfight and it's going to be hard putting up points, sometimes we like to get our defense out on the field first, and maybe, you know, maybe there's some sort of turnover on the special teams on their part, or maybe they have a turnover on their first series because the kids are so geared up, or, you know, there's a lot more that can go wrong usually on offense than there is on defense. So
right.
I'm leaning towards kicking the ball off, but I'll talk to my captains and kind of get a feel for what they want to do on that.
Okay. And what about the health of the team? I've been kind of racked up the last couple games. What are we looking at tonight?
Yep. So the one guy that will be out is Gilbert Isaacs, number 76. He's our right tackle, biggest guy on the team. He was out last week versus Herman. He'll be out again this week, but he'll be back against Waterville, which is good news, next week. And everybody else is feeling pretty good. Croy Albee suited up this week for the first time in a long time, and and he's feeling pretty good. He got out there for a couple days, and, you know, we kind of put him through his paces, but we didn't go too hard with him. And talking to him after practice, he said he felt pretty good, and he may or may not suit up tonight. We're not sure. If he does suit up, I don't know how many reps he would get in the game. We've repped, you know, other guys in his spot.
He's going to be tough to keep off the field if he's suited up.
Yeah, that's for sure.
He'll be sneaking out there.
He might. And who knows how the game could go, you know. And, you know, Elijah Joyce has been filling that role at fullback, and we have all the confidence in the world in Elijah. He's been just a quality football player for us for a long time, and he's a tough kid. So, you know, we feel real confident with him at fullback. And, you know, if Elijah's feeling good, you know, and running the ball hard, and we'll probably keep him in there. But the thing about Elijah, he plays on both sides of the ball, and he plays almost every special team. So sometimes he needs a break during the game. So that might be a good opportunity to get Croy in there if he does suit up tonight. And, you know, we also have Alden Fournier that runs fullback for us. So at the fullback spot right now, we have decent depth, and we also can move Elijah to one of the halfbacks and put Alden Fournier at fullback or Croy. So I'm feeling pretty good there, but once again, the way games sometimes go, you know, first quarter you got two sprained ankles and you're saying, uh-oh, right, we don't have the depth we thought we did. So, you know, we'll see how it goes, but it's good news that Croy's back in pads, and, you know, he's been excited to be out there, and we're excited to have him there.
How have practices gone during the week?
Yeah, we've had a really good week of practice. You know, it was hot early on in the week, and last night was a little better, and of course tonight's better football weather. But, you know, the kids have been taking that real seriously. You know, a couple of weeks ago, Bucksport week, I thought one of the days it was a Tuesday of that week, and the Monday before, we'd watch tape, and the guys were a little loose, and then we got on the practice field, and they were a little loose, and, you know, and sure enough, we thought that showed up the first half of that Bucksport game. Bucksport clearly outplayed us, and, you know, we made a lot of mistakes, and I just felt like, you know, maybe we didn't have the mental focus that we needed, and we talked about that after that week, and last week, we had an excellent week of practice. We had great focus, and this week, the same. We've had a real good Tuesday, Wednesday work day, and then yesterday was our pregame, and we had an excellent pregame yesterday. So we've had a good week of prep, and you know, we're as ready as we can be, and you know, we'll go down there and give MCI everything we have.
What time are you leaving the school today?
Yeah, we're going to leave at 2:45, and you know, by car, what's that? About an hour and 20 minutes, maybe 25 minutes to Pittsfield, give or take. Maybe an hour and a half on the high side. By bus, it probably will take about an hour and a half, and that will give us, get us down there in plenty of time to stretch our legs. And I mean, once again, the kids and myself, I mean, we're not accustomed to playing down there.
Right, you know? It's a whole new stadium. It's a whole new field. It's everything's new.
Yeah, I mean, we just haven't played this program in years. I mean, the last time I coached against MCI, I was an assistant for Tuggy McKay, and it was one of the first years I was here. That was probably, you know, 20, 22 years ago.
Well, and so, I mean, it's all new. It's where do you change? Where do you park? Where, you know, everything is brand new.
Yeah. I mean, we had mom email us today. She had heard that the field was not at the school, which it is actually at the school. But, yeah, I mean, I have no idea where we're supposed to go. I don't know where the locker rooms are. I don't know anything about it. So, get us down there in plenty of time to figure all that out, and then we can focus on football after that.
All right, what do you want to say to everybody? Mike's yours.
Yeah, once again, thank you for your continued support. We had a great crowd out here versus Herman, and the kids really did feel it. You know, they got a lot of pats on the back from people in the community that were at the game, and, you know, it just feels nice that we know that people are behind us. And, you know, if you can't be down to Pittsfield tonight, then maybe you can make it down to the Waterville game the following Friday. That'll be another tough game, and if not that, we'll be back for our homecoming versus Leavitt the following Friday night, and, you know, just hope that people can come out and support us. So,
all right, Coach, best of luck tonight, and we'll see you down in the field.
All right, thanks, Chris. All right, thanks, Chris.